someone to basically kick on dirt into this, and I scoop it up and we see it. Okay, we're at Salem Creek, and we're going to be looking for macroinvertebrates and using a couple of different techniques that you can, people at home can try on their own. This is a kick mat made of industry and cow. Okay, so let's start with the kick mat. It's got to have a mix of rock and mud, and you also want areas where you see ripples in the water, because that's where there's lots of oxygen. So, I'm going to hold this, and I'll hold it here. If you just kick mud and everything into it, keep going. Yeah, good. That's it. Oh,
you got a lot of rocks. Great.
Okay.
Right,
let's
see
what we got. Oops. Now let's let some of these rocks go off.
Too many heavy rocks.
Yes, yeah, it's.
This part's hard.
There's
to
a
pick.
Shiny little thing up there.
This?
No,
Two of them.
Oh, right there.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Those are actually, one thing about macroinvertebrates is they're an indicator of water quality.
Yeah, just move over.
Or you get a tub like this and a little sieve, or maybe you have some takeout containers like this where you can put the water and muck and look for the macroinvertebrates there. So Evelyn's going to demonstrate.
Water in it. Stir around. Let's see. Picture of the dinosaur.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Ooh.
Do you think?
Evelyn, could you grab these shoes for me?